familiar wailing of air raid sirens, a reminder that the war stops for no one.
We need to go. Sorry. We need to go.
This is Joe Biden's first visit to Kyiv since the full-scale invasion began almost a year ago.
Morning, Mr. President.
A surprise trip and a striking show of solidarity.
How are the children?
The White House says it notified Moscow of the president's trip hours before he left the U.S.
Putin thought Ukraine was weak and the West was divided. And 1 year later, the evidence is right here in this room. We stand here together.
Joe Biden announced a fresh round of Russian sanctions that target the country's elite and promised more than $700 million in new military aid for Ukraine.
Such a significant package is a clear signal that Russian attempts at revenge will not stand a chance.
Freedom is priceless. It's worth fighting for as long as it takes. And that's how long we're going to be with you, Mr. President, for as long as it takes.
We'll do it.
Thank you.
I am speechless. I am very happy. Because he came to us. This means everything.
The US president's next stop is Poland, where he's holding talks with NATO leaders from Eastern Europe.
There might have been celebration in the capital over the president's visit, but here in Kramatorsk in the east of the country, the feeling is very different. Air raid sirens sound and the threat of this war feels very real.
For soldiers in battle, the promise of more weapons from the West is a lifeline. Ammunition supplies are running low, and experts predict the war is about to enter a deadly new phase. Isabella Higgins, ABC News, Kramatorsk.